Hello everybody, welcome back to White Art Gaming. As we continue this playthrough of Baldur's Gate 3. This is part 8. In the last part, we spoke to party members in the camp. We turned down several sexual advances. And then we cleared up the rest of the goblin camp. Then we tried to get through Mountain Pass, but it said we weren't leveled up enough. So the plan for today is to try and find any side quests that need completing. Basically, talk to everybody, try and explore the whole area, and probably take out the rest of the goblins in the Blighted Village, because that will then give us some XP as well. So, let's carry on. Even though it's red, I assume this stuff's actually just been left behind by the Zevlor group. Can I pick up a red one? Oh, yes, I can. Is that going to camp supplies or just the actual inventory? It is. Doesn't cost very much. I think it's just if I drop it. Drop.
Cursed to put my hands on everything.
Freshly turned soil shifts beneath your feet as you approach the grave.
I don't think grave digging is going to be something I'm going to get into.
You close your eyes, finding a moment of peace. Here lies Cannon. He gave his life defending others. He will be missed.
More for me.
I don't understand why we're climbing on the trunks.
Move,
This up here is where...
What I wouldn't give for a good rest about now.
Up there, I think, is where this was. Where the telescope.
You peer through the telescope.
Oh, it's a dragon. That's four on, is that correct? I think I'm reading that correctly. Yeah. Or up to four. It's one to four. Yeah, is it one? I think that's what that means. Yeah. Because it gives a 2 to 5 bonus.
See a dragon circling like a bird of prey, hunting.
I move to the left.
The telescope points to the left. The telescope points straight ahead.
The right.
The telescope points to the right. I was worried we would have to get into the fence.
It'll take a while for us all to recover.
Guard.
But you've helped us take the first step. Of course.
I can actually. I want to. I'm assuming pressing T would actually make this stay in place, but it doesn't. I'm gonna actually keep that crossbow for now and see. Torch. Shovel. Push to sleep. Gives it plus one bonus to stealth checks. Gives me advantage on the saving throws if I get killed. be able to make my own armor at one point. Special rest, you gain another one spell slot when you hit a critical hit with a thief spell. Well, I could get some more souls. Souls of revivery. I keep saying revivery, but revivery. How much do they cost? 69 each. Giggly. I do that with my brace. It's gonna be 500.
May you keep balance.
Feel that one later.
So that restores that.
Never wanted the easy path.
Master Helsa was the first druid. None of us can match him in battle.
I have something to ask.
The grove suffered.
You did this grove a great favor. And now leave the rest to us.
I think it's high time you all left. Our sacred grove has sheltered you enough.
Why were you drawn the attack?
Within the inner sanctum, of course. It is not for us to fight your battles.
They were attacking your settlement. You disgust
me. I assure you, the feeling is mutual.
It is dead.
looks empty.
These people are assholes, so I'm gonna put them blind, I think. Someone here? Or is it a cow? Strange ops. Makes you uneasy trying to turn why. Is that the bonus on?
Something's off. This creature isn't what it appears to be.
We're free of the goblins, but the grove is changed. Wounded. The days ahead won't be easy, but we'll manage. We have to.
Don't move into a pass.
The tieflings have gone. Good. I wish them well, but they crowded us for far too long.
Assume nothing.
Sharp as ever.
Looking ahead. Another step forward.
I know you stopped the goblins, but I can't stop looking over my shoulder. Makes it hard to sleep at night.
You think you saved us? You just prolonged the inevitable. Sooner or later, other outsiders will bring trouble to the Grove.
Our guests are finally gone. I thought they'd never leave.
We could go and talk to that doctor, Nettie, was that her name?
give me trouble now.
Inspire allies and bardic inspiration, also gain.
What am I needed?
You, that looks
sharp as ever.
Probably my favorite so far as well.
Should find my step.
May he rest in Summer Oak forever. I apologize. I must have some time to myself.
Goblins may be gone, but it cost Master Halson his life. I'm sorry neither of us could save you from that tadpole. I hope it ends well for you.
What else do we need?
He wants to jump, wants to bite. His eyes dart back and forth as he sniffs the air. He can't see them anymore, but he can smell them. Many, many strangers. The wolf bares his teeth. He doesn't take orders from you. He'll chase you down if not for his master.
Don't mind if I do.
steals it. No, I said I was going to rob one blind, but I'm not going to steal a religious artifact.
Wits and blades, always sharp.
Indolence breeds madness.
Don't waste a step.
Peace. Enjoy it while it lasts.
I still want to kill you. No, I won't. Because I've killed the person who's meant to be operating it, it doesn't work, so I will fast travel. It's like I actually haven't gone down that way, so that is a new area to explore. I'm gonna quick save just in case that happens again. That's the other pathway leading to the bridge to the public camp. Take up five buried chests in a single playthrough.
Enough! You know you have her.
Please! You just want Mayrina back.
Lads, for the love of all that is holy, I've never clapped eyes on your poor sister.
Drop the act, hag.
You was the last to see Mayrina.
Just let her go. Please.
Thank goodness you're here, sweetie. I don't know what's come over these boys.
Stop this! We won't ask again!
How about you all just calm down? What's going on here?
Careful! Don't trust a word out of her mouth. Our sister went to the hag, and we ain't seen her since.
Hand over heart, I don't know their sister. I will gladly help you all look for her, though.
Enough. Where is she?
Sweetie, be careful!
She's with the hag!
Don't bloody stand there gaping! Get her!
This is my time. Watch and learn.
Oh, my stars! I didn't mean for this to happen.
Do you know this Marina they mentioned?
She's their little sister, and she's staying with me. This is all my fault, but I made a promise. Mayrina begged me not to breathe a word if they came looking for her. And my word is my bond. That poor thing will be distraught. We can't let her know it would break her poor heart. I'd best get going, but please stop by my house. I'd like to thank you proper.
Not sure if I actually
trust you. I suspect we've been played for fools.
Yes, I kind of agree. Joel and Mia, don't get mad, I mean it. I'm only leaving us now so you don't panic and do something stupid. I'm going to the hag. I owe it to Connor to make things right. You know he'd do the same for me. I'll be back soon. So not a word to Mam, alright? She has enough on her plate. Marina. Mayrina.
Wonder if the gods are watching me. What's in here? I'll take that. Anything of use?
Chill runs up your spine. You feel like you're being watched. The place has a quiet sense of calm. You can't see anything strange. Bloodbath. Someone, something, made quick work of the place.
No ordinary creature did this. Redcaps ripped the place to pieces.
Something over there. Let's see what this does.
It's the woman's house. Randall. Hello.
Ah, a fellow wanderer. Forgive the aroma.
You catch a waft of something foul, metallic, and sickly sweet.
Blood.
Powdered iron vine. Most monsters will think twice before making a meal of me. An old hunter's trick. If you can't mask your scent, spoil it.
Who are you?
Today? The same as you. A humble supplicant. Come to bargain with the lady of this house. That is why you came to her lair, I take it. To bargain.
The lady of this house?
A more innocent name than some I could call her. But it is what she is that ought to concern you. Her kind have hidden among us since the first darkness. And their knowledge is matched only by their spite. Know how to ask, and they'll share that knowledge. If you're fool enough to pay their price.
Speak plainly, what's she?
A powerful friend, a terrible foe. That I cannot decide for you. For my part, I need her knowledge. The thing I hunt has gone to ground. If she can tell me how to flush him out, I'll pay whatever price she asks.
Who is it you're hunting?
Truth is like a blade, my friend. We can arm ourselves with it, or just as easily find it pressed against our throat. I would not put you in danger.
Maybe I can help with your hunt.
Offer, but to accept it would be no kindness at all, I assure you. Besides, I must survive what waits in that house. One terror at a time, hmm?
Save this time.
I don't want a crumb left on that plate, girl.
Auntie Ethel, please. One more bite and this pie is gonna come back up to say hello.
Don't make me get the wooden spoon. You're eating for two, so get to it. Oh, if it isn't my hero. You took ages. Come in, come in. Feel free to relax yourself and have a cuppa, hmm? Gods, grant me patience. Eat up, Mayrina. I won't say it again.
You treat all your guests so poorly.
You're quite right, Petal. Forgive me if I get a bit sharp. My work wears something awful on me. You see, I help people from all over Faerun. And you, Petal, well, you need a lot of help. That wriggler swimming in your brain juice is a bit of an inconvenience, isn't it? Busybodies are not appreciated around here.
Must you stick out your neck for every dimwit in distress?
I'll talk about your wriggler, and that's it. Last warning. You want to play the hero so badly? Fine. Let's make this interesting.
You blink and the wilderness changes. A swamp, stinking and insidious, assaults your senses.
With your new friends. Bye-bye.
Hag can't have gone far.
Make way!
missing.
I will ascend.
Taking position.
No holding back. No time to waste. Of the gate.
Still breathing, despite everything.
Something the matter?
Breathe deep and move.
Begins an elegant curse of bends and a harsh sloping scroll. Ethel forces our work at Baldur's Gate. The mewing wretches are trying to etch me out of my own territory. I've killed at least four of their agents. None have talked, not yet at least. I doubt you hear anything beyond the bleating of a ridiculous sheep. If you hear a whisper, send word immediately.
Thank you.
here.
Speak.
Something the matter?
Around. Bit.
Oh, enough waiting. I crave blood.
You haven't got any.
My faith will guide me.
Either. Give food to you. Got some large ones as well, didn't we? Large. Get that to whale. Salting, no. Fruiting, space of poison.
You are as thick as they come, sweetness. This is my personal playhouse, and you don't have an invite. Get out!
Tell me where my ring is.
Has that wriggler eaten your brain already? Leave, or you'll end up in tonight's stew. You'll go nicely with Mayrina. She's already marinating. Please!
Here goes. What's that?
What my darling Macron. She wished for the mind of a genius, but that silly head crossed me.
Please.
You feel crushing waves of fear as the presence within the door recoils. It can't let people through. Not again.
What happened last time you were
there? Images flash. A man cowering, a bag open at his feet. Gold coins spilling onto the floor. His cries for mercy are cut short as the hag slices into him, dismembering him painstakingly, limb by limb. She cackles, the man's remaining flesh twisted and contorted, becoming the twisted surface of the door before you. Flee, you feel it cry.
I'm not afraid of that attack.
A scene appears in your mind. Two paladins and a cleric marching through the door, shrouded in the glow of the divine. Weapons brandished, they charge into the hag's lair. Screams of terror pierce the air.
You let them in? Naughty. That's a decade for each. You're mine for 30 more years, Petal.
You see an image of blue skies and sunshine as the door shudders a warning. Run. Its form flickers, and you realize that the door is transparent.
I see for you.
You see the hag, eyes bright with glee, as she sets fire to the door. With a jerk, you're pulled from the vision. The presence within shrinks, begging you not to run through it.
Look. Don't. No. No! Don't look. Mustn't look. Mustn't see. I see it. What's to come?
You realize there's magic at work. Some type of spell. An illusion.
Me. Dead. Dead! Flesh rotten, bone shining!
Hey, look at me.
No. No! Can't stop! Can't! Gods, don't hurt me! Oh, please! Please! Please, please, please!
Safe with me, I swear.
No! No! Monster!
Damn, he's gonna fight me, isn't
he? Mind dripping! Flesh peeling! Mind flayer!
Take breath and roar.
No, 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 no! I'm sorry!
No intention of letting that happen.
Stop! Please! Please!
Hint of life from within the door. You see the hag, eyes bright with glee. With a jerk, you...
Stop. Please! Please! Away! Away! Don't look. Don't!
Disease that ravaged him.
Open.
Wait. Wait. Don't. Don't.
Anything of use?
Gentle lark. He wished to know what was to come.
the barest hint of life from within.
Moving ahead?
Don't look. Don't! Stop! Please! Please!
I've had a bad of holding.
Suits you. Just relax. See the world with fresh eyes. And let your dear old Auntie Ethel look after you.
The stench of rot is a slap to the face. Suddenly she is there, beside you, behind you. Inside you.
Yes, I have you now. Don't worry. Auntie is going to take good care of you.
What are you playing at?
Pavrook, remove the mask. Now!
Away! Don't look. Don't! Stop. Please. Please! Don't look. Don't!
Feel the barest hint of light. You see the hag, eyes bright with a jerk. Presence within the scene appeared. Weapon scream.
You let them in?
The door, its form flickers, and you realize that the door is transparent. You see the hag. She walks through the door, its form shimmering. The lightest touch of hope brushes your mind. As the presence within retreats.
Stop! Please! Please!
Still alive. So that's...
Away! Away! Don't look. Don't!
Time to press ahead.
Ah!
Time to rest.
Well, I did it, but I had to kill a shadow. I had to do so. I think I'll use those arrows and things.
Get on with it.
Ah!
me hurt them.
More dead.
Today you fall.
Shouldn't have wished to live in more interesting times.
People.
Never mind.
Okay. I didn't particularly want to have to kill
no
them, but
please.
Just didn't think I had a choice. I could have helped him out, but. Thank you.
way. I've got a long road ahead. I need more pockets.
Fading fast. I must heal.
No time to waste. I wonder what the next move is. Got to press on.
These boots have seen everything.
There, in the cage.
Step careful.
You come to my home, interfere in my business, and now have the gall to face me in the heart of my lair. You petulant bollocks! I'll rip your spine out, your asshole! I'll use your blood to spice my stew! I'll keep you alive until I've sucked the marrow from your bones! And then I'll bring you back and do it all over again!
Just get out of here! Please!
You want the girl so bad? Fine!
That should work.
No holding back. Finding my way.
Yeah.
I go. You can take me on.
This is my time.
I'd die that way through the thing.
Have seen everything. All right then.
This is my time. Fleet of foot.
Thank you.
position. Taste my fury. Do you think I made you a hero?
Finding my way. Fearless. I'd better hurry.
Don't waste a step.
Talk to me.
Forever dauntless. Making my move.
Victory awaits. Make way.
I want to regret you more. Greed.
Forever dauntless.
Powerful for me right now.
couldn't have wished to live in more interesting times.
Maybe I'll replay that one. Well, I would like to say I haven't spent the last hour trying to defeat Auntie Ethel, but unfortunately that isn't the case. I did manage to sneak into the back here and steal some of her stuff. But I just do not think I am anywhere near high level enough to defeat her at this point. Just cast Ray of Sickness, hold person, and her claws attack. Can take me out in one go if it's a great call. So I just think she's so much higher level than I am at the moment. I just don't think I would need a lot of good luck to defeat her, I think.
Defender of the people.
What now?
Sharp as ever.
I did manage to get a good this ever seeing eye, which allows me to cast protection from good and evil. I did get some fairly good loot out of stuff.
These boots have seen.
I just want to see if I can. I'm pretty sure I can leave if I want to. I'm in the same place, but obviously it's not sunshine and bright at all. That was all an illusion being cast. But I'll come back and deal with her later. So right now I just think she's too powerful to deal with.
Entire body shakes. It ribbits erratically as if in pain.
hunter's path.
Swift and lethal. What should I do? Taste my fury. Let's end this.
Where am I needed?
My faith will guide me. Path. Let's move. Don't waste a step.
This isn't good.
I'm not going to last much longer.
A long rest. Yep.
Need something?
How does someone become a vampire?
It's simple. Just find a vampire that will drink your blood and turn you into a vampire spawn. They're obedient puppet. In theory, the next step is to drink their blood. Once you've done that, you're free. And a true vampire.
In theory?
People think the biggest threat to a vampire is a cleric with a stake. It's not. The biggest threat to a vampire is another vampire. They're scheming, paranoid, power-hungry beasts. So why would any vampire give up control over a spawn to create a competitor? Trust me, it doesn't happen.
I met a monster hunter in the swamp, it's not after you, is he?
Excuse me? Not every monster hunter we stumble across is trying to kill me. Then again, we're not exactly keeping a low profile out here. Fine, I'll bite. What did he look like? A girl? What are those vagabonds? Why would they... Cazador. Of course he'd send a girl to hunt me down.
Who is Cazador, exactly?
Cazador Zar is a vampire lord in Baldur's Gate. The patriarch of his coven and a monster obsessed with power. He turned me nearly 200 years ago. I became his spawn. And he became my tormentor.
But what a monster hunter work for a vampire?
They may have no idea who they're working for. Cazador likely paid someone to pay someone to call in a favor. And here we are. He doesn't do simple plans. Not if he has a complex one that pits a dozen enemies against each other. No. This hunter is a message. Cazador's letting me know that even out here, he can get to me. He wants me back.
Don't worry, you're safe.
Safe? You think I'm safe? Do you know the power a vampire lord possesses? He can change shape, turn into mist, call wolves to do his bidding, shrug off blows like they're nothing. He could walk into our camp tonight and kill you with his bare hands. And you'd be lucky if death was the worst thing that happened to you.
All right, to what do you suggest?
First, we have to... I don't know. Well, if we kill his lackeys, he'll just send more. We just have to be vigilant, keep our wits about us, and kill any monster hunters on sight. We can probably make an exception for Will. Probably.
Speak.
Have you thought about making use of the tentacles?
Mark my words. This power would be no blessing, but a curse. You might as well ask me to gouge out my eyes for the promise of sight, or slice off my tongue for the promise of taste. Consume all the gate tadpoles you wish. I'm not so craven.
I was gonna say, I think that's gonna be a very hard persuade.
And when the tadpole has stretched to every pore and slithered through every vein, what then? It won't hear my screams. It won't care if I beg. I will be remade in its image. My faith in Vlakith will guide me, and my own might will sustain me. I have no need of this depraved power.
Well met.
What do you make of Raphael? Stone Eye, did you mean in battle?
A most vicious one, in fact. It's made from pure bloodstone, carved from the Galena Mountains just north of the Moonsea. A reminder that sometimes blood must be shed and sacrifices must be made. Ah. But that story is reserved for lifetime friends and calmer days.
Don't let me drag you away. Enjoy yourself. You've earned a night of revelry.
Oh, you'll have to speak slowly. I'm finding it quite difficult to concentrate with my condition gnawing at my insides like a teething displacer kitten.
That is most gratifying to hear. May I?
I just got this one, so...
Thank you. Any effect.
Oh, Mistra, have mercy on us all. Listen, I need to speak to you, to all of you. It would be unconscionable of me to remain silent. I might just be about to remedy that. You have to know who I was. You have to know who I really am. What I am is a walking shadow of the promise I once held. I'm what one might call a wizard prodigy. And from an early age, could not only control the weave, but compose it. Much like a musician or a poet. Such was my skill that it earned me the attention of the mother of magic herself. The Lady of Mysteries. The goddess Mistra. She revealed herself to me and she became my teacher. In time, she became my muse. And later, even my lover.
Bold. Few would dare to reduce them goddess to their muse.
I am, after all, the villain of the tale. We enjoyed each other's company. Body, mind, and soul. But even so, I desired more. You see, no matter how powerful a wizard we mortals can become, we never scratch more than the surface of the weave. Mistra keeps us in check. There are boundaries she doesn't let us cross. Yet, every time I was with her, I stood on the precipice, gazing into the wonders that lay beyond. I sought to cross her boundaries.
Gonna guess she punished you. You thought you knew better than Mistra, you're more of a fool than I thought.
Quite. I tried to convince her. I pouted. I pleaded. Swore my ambition was only to serve her better. She only smiled and told me to be contented. But inconceivable as it seems to me now, I shared a bed with a goddess. Yet I wasn't satisfied. So I sought to prove myself worthy to her instead. We come now to the crux of my folly. Shall I share the story behind it, or would you rather head straight to its sordid finale?
I mean,
suffice it to say, I obtained an obscure and ancient book that had locked away inside a much coveted prize. It was a fragment of primal weave locked out of time, locked away from Mistra herself. What if, I thought, what if, after all this time, I could return this lost part of herself to the goddess? I was certain that this deed of raw power, draped in romance, would convince Mistra to take me by the hand and welcome me into her hitherto forbidden domains. I was mistaken. I obtained the fabled book and took it into my study. As for what happened next. Here. Place your hand over my heart. Let me show you.
You feel the tadpole quiver as you realize Gale is letting you in. Into the dark. You see through Gale's eyes, staring down the corridors of a dread memory. A book bound and suddenly opened. Inside there are no pages, only a swirling mass of blackest weave that pounces. Its teeth, its claws, it's unstoppable as it digs through and becomes part of you. And gods, is it ever hungry.
Thankfully, the moment I absorbed the fragment wasn't enough to kill me outright. It was only the beginning. This Netherese blight, this orb, for lack of a better word, is balled up inside my chest. And it needs to be fed. As long as I absorb traces of the weave from potent enough sources, remains quiet. Were it ever to fully destabilize, however. Rather worse, actually. I will erupt. I don't know the exact magnitude of the eruption, but given my studies of Netherese magic, I'd say even a fragment as small as the one I carry, it'd level a city the size of Waterdeep. We might chance upon a king's collection of magical artifacts around the corner. We might cross paths with a miracle round the bend. Then again, we might not. All of this, it must feel like a betrayal. Say the word, and we'll part ways. Once I'd step out of the protective aura of the artifact, it wouldn't be long before the Absolute overtakes me. I'd never let that happen, so I'd aim for a swift end. I would consume sub-midnight tears and venture as deep into the Underdark as I possibly could, till they cloud my eyes forever. With a bit of luck, I'd manage to make it to a Mind Flayer colony so that when the orb erupts, one loud last song of vengeance would reverberate through the dark. Wouldn't be a heroic end, but coarsely poetic enough in its justice.
I'm an optimist.
That is a great relief. Oh, a great relief indeed. You truly are a soul that steals my own. From all my new rallied heart, I thank you. I thank you all. I understand if you stand against me. I'm humbled if you stand with me. Either way, I will do my best not to let you down. I stand at a precipice, but if you do not give up hope, neither shall I. I'll fight. I'll resist as long as I can. Now, even I am tired of the sound of my own voice. Let us venture forth.
Something the matter? I know. I don't understand how exactly, but I felt it go to you. It's important. Keep it close.
You don't want it back.
I do, but the artifact has a will of its own and powers to enforce it. It likely won't let me take it back. The best I can do is to stay close, bide my time. Eventually, I'll need to take it. Then, I'll have to see what can be done about that.
How did you get the artifact to begin with?
It's not the sort of thing I can just tell anyone. Let's see if we can build up some trust first.
And also, guys, I've actually decided I don't like the way I look. I'm just gonna check with Widows and see if I can get horse and revived. I don't.
Fate spins along as it should. Dost thou require a new ally? Or mayhaps a resurrection instead?
See what this does.
Where to next?
Hello. Quite the cozy setup you have here. I'll just make myself comfortable. Thank you so much. My research turned up a rather brilliant technique that seems quite actionable. It's not too deep, just behind the orbital socket. I could attempt an extraction. I've a needle in my tunic, after all.
How many times have you done this? You don't really seem like the type to be trained. Do any kind of surgery.
You won't find a more learned opinion on this matter, I assure you.
Yeah, but you're an idiot.
You only have a matter of days to live. Don't dally, my friend.
You'd have seconds to live if you might fucking know. Pardon my French.
I promised I'd be back. Don't worry. I have things under control. For now. I see you've been using the powers the tadpole gives you. Good. But things haven't gone as you expected. You hoped a druid as powerful as Halsin might be able to remove your tadpole. But he couldn't. You're desperate to be rid of it. Understandable.
But you're looking for solutions in the wrong places.
I'm not sure if I absolutely 100% trust you, despite the fact I created you. So what should I be doing?
Your parasite is unusual. It is wrapped in magic that prevents its removal. Until the source of the tadpole's magic is destroyed, any attempt to remove it will kill you. You were lucky that Halsey knew this. His instincts are right. The parasites are merely a symptom of a greater sickness in Faerun.
What is the sickness?
The absolute aims are not yet clear to me, but its progress towards domination is clear. These parasites are more than a lithid spawn. They are vessels for control. The infected hear the voice of the Absolute and believe it to be a god. That is how the cult of the Absolute is spreading. The highest of their rank, the True Souls, carry a tadpole just like yours. It is how they receive their orders. It is what makes them obey. When the order to transform is given, it will not be a matter of days. They will be Mind Flayers in an instant. Were it not for my protection, so would you.
You're like a spirit of the artifact or something, aren't you? It just suddenly clicked. Then, because the artifact's protecting me. Is she the artifact? How is it that you protect me?
I have powers of my own. Unique powers. But know that we are alike. Just like you, I was infected with a Mind Flayer parasite. Just like you, I seek to be free of it. I've been trying to escape from this evil for a long time. Once, I almost succeeded. Now, through you, I've been given a new chance. You can go where I cannot. And I can protect you from that evil. If we work together, we may turn this around. Hells, they need me. I have to go.
Is there anything I can do to help you?
No. I can handle this. For now. The power I used to protect you, I stole it from someone. They want it back. I will hold them off for as long as I can, but sooner or later, I will be worn down. You must discover the source of the magic that controls the parasites before that happens. The cultists are gathering at Moonrise Towers. Use the powers your parasite gives you to convince them you are one of them. And when you find the source of their magic, destroy it. Go. Our freedom depends on it.
I had another dream last night. The visitor came to me and ordered me to penetrate the heart of the very cult that's spreading the infection. It gave me a tadpole gift, too. Just like it did the first time it appeared. I suppose it hoped this would help. At first, I thought we should avoid these gifts no matter what advantage we gain. And yet, I can't help recall the words of my father. The best plan is the one that works. These powers could be enough to edge us towards victory. Very well. If it's mind games these parasites wish to play, and we'll win. Are you sure? The blade stands at the ready. And just when things were warming up.
I had another visit from that dream figure. I take it you did too. It claims that if we infiltrate the heart of the cult that's giving out these parasites, we'll find the answers with. It gave me another gift, too. Just like it did the first time it did. And if that fails, then there's always... Now, was there anything else? Darling, I thought you'd never ask. Lead on.
I had another dream. Whoever's reaching out to us truly does seem opposed to the Absolute. Perhaps we truly have a secret protector. Or...
If you're sure. Fine. I'll be here whenever you rediscover your taste in company.
Visitor again. She even offered me given the magnitude of what we're up against, I see no harm in considering the benefit this offer might afford us. Could be the only way to reach this source in one piece. As existed, any opportunities for us to indulge our tadpole's capabilities are hardly on the same scale. Trifles, when one considers the bigger picture. With pleasure. Lead on.
How do I distinguish what was mine and what was...
Watch your back.
Is that blood? No, never mind. Let's get going.
Thank you.
ruled your taste.
Thank you.
still alive. So that's progress.
Moving in.
That orb seems powerful. What can it do once it's extracted?
Nothing good can come of it unless it is contained. Why?
It might be useful.
Silence.
Me yet.
What path lies before me?
Life, now yours will be taken in turn. A fair exchange, perhaps.
All's well that ends. Not as bad as it could have.
How much further can I go?
Violence hasn't gone unnoticed. It's about to be returned in kind.
I wonder if this is worth the cost.
Never wanted the easy path.
time to rest. Matters.
Still do something. No.
Sometimes the only way out is through. What path lies before me?
Thank you.